Yeah, I mean, speaking of that book, you know, I have visualized us having like 7 more kids.
Oh my God. Well, that one's not happening.
Yeah, I remember, you know, pulling up to games when I was younger. My thought process was, I'm about to go out here and show out. And now that I done got a little older, you know, my mental process is like, remain calm, walk into the locker room, got to lead these guys. When chaos is going around, everybody is looking for the calm person, right? Like, well, ever since I started meditating, mm-hmm. I don't really go into panic mode. I just feel like I walk around way more peaceful when I spend 30 minutes of just nothing, complete silence, just my thoughts, and be able to like organize. It's kind of like meditating is like cleaning up your room, cleaning out your brain, organizing your brain to start your day.
I feel like it took me a while to like really, you know, get meditating down, and like it's not like a moment where you could just like literally just put a block on your mind.
Exactly. It's crazy. It's awesome. And meditating and calming my mind, you know, I've been able to visualize a lot. I'm like, I mean, you see me running routes around the house, studying all the time on my iPad.
The funniest is when you like look in the mirror and like line up with yourself. And I'm like, oh my God, what is he doing now?
In my mind, I'm visualizing, yeah. Right? I mean, it's all about getting comfortable, right? The more comfortable you are, the more confident you are. And so that's what I just try to do, try to gain confidence. A lot of people don't understand is when we're in a huddle, you gotta know within like 5 seconds exactly where you gotta line up and exactly what play you gotta run based off the particular coverage that defense is running. So you have to be smart in order to play this game.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I'm studying these plays to the point that when I get in the game, it's everything's like second nature. You know, you've done it with me plenty of times where I'm like, here, take these flashcards and trips right, 62 drag. I'm like, okay, I'm on the outside. I got a slant route, you know, and I'm the first read. I should be expecting the ball right here.
I remember we were in Pantera Plaza. We were sitting in the living room and you had just got signed to the Broncos and you were just talking about how like you need to learn how to relax, and we were talking about like breathing and meditation, and I was like, you know what, you should read this book. And then I remember sat there and you like pulled it up on your phone and you're like, oh my God, this is amazing.
Yeah, I remember I wanted to buy it for all of my
teammates. Yes, and remember you said this. You're like, if everybody on the team reads this book, we're going to get a Super Bowl. We're going to go to the Super Bowl.
That was in 2014 when I got that book. Another one of my favorite things about the book also is it talks about it challenges you to give out 7 compliments a day.
Oh, yeah. Whatever you give to the universe or to other people, it comes back to you. So, like, if you want love, you have to give it, you know? Whatever you give, you receive. It's crazy though, because it's like I see the change. Like, thing, it's not like about you anymore. It's always like, man, I hope we win. Like,
I hope, win.
You know, I hope we win. And like, even after like the game, like in the beginning, you used to be mad for days. You know, you weren't really that approachable. But then, like, I feel like now you dwell on it for like that night, and then the next day you're over. You're like, okay, what could I do to make myself better? Like, that's gone. It's in the past. And no, I just feel like you handle it better. You're more patient and calm. You're so much more calm than you.
See, that's a compliment.
So do I get one back?
Yeah. Nice driving.